Hey, Chris, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com. A report issued this week by the United States Conference of Mayors cited that while 8.7 million jobs have been regained since the 2008 economic collapse, those jobs are paying much less, an average of 23% less. The president of the Conference of Mayors, Kevin Johnson, said, "While the economy is picking up steam, income inequality and wage gaps are an alarming trend that must be addressed." He said, "We cannot put our heads in the sand on these issues." What he cites as income inequality is the annual wage in sectors where jobs were lost, like manufacturing and construction, where during the recession it was $61,637, but the average wage of new jobs through the second quarter of 2014 is now reduced to $47,131, according to this week's report. This change represents a loss of $93 billion in wages, according to the Conference of Mayors report. The losses documented in construction and manufacturing were replaced with jobs in hospitality, health care, and administrative support. The mayor's report shows the gap between low and higher income households is growing and likely will continue in the future. In 2012, 73% of metro areas had a larger share of poorer households, those making less than $35,000 a year, than upper-income households making over $75,000. One dynamic of this report is that several categories of older, higher-paying jobs are being replaced with newer categories of lower-paying jobs. New job creation establishes a higher standard of living baseline for individuals and families at a level that is much less than what people were previously used to. Couple that with the significant yet unacknowledged inflation we have experienced since 2008, and the average person and family is already many steps behind the proverbial eight ball. Unacknowledged, masked, hidden inflation that eats away and destroys one standard of living like a virulent strain of flesh-eating bacteria, coupled with new jobs that position people at a lower starting point from the get-go, reflect an economic double whammy that remains invisible to most people. Most people accept the official inflation numbers, and most are happy just to get a job. That most refuse to run the numbers and look reality square in the eye and see how bad it really is. The survival of the current big lie depends on how long people will tolerate phony inflation numbers and pretend that a job, any job, is enough to maintain their standard of living. At some point, something is going to give. The periodic cry in the media for things like fast food workers to have a $15 an hour minimum wage isn't an outlandish suggestion. It's a cry for help, for wage inflation to be allowed to enter the equation, to catch people up to a point where their wages will support a basic lifestyle that has been ravaged by unacknowledged inflation. But allowing wage inflation would be like allowing gold to inflate and reflect its true market value. It would set off alarm bells throughout the market. And those kinds of alarm bells are something they will fight and suppress until they no longer can. And in the meantime, we will all suffer. And until next time, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com, reminding you to follow us on Twitter @ConquerChange. Thanks, Chris.